Creator God, whose Son Jesus Christ lived once in Palestine, yet whose arms flung wide on the cross, embrace all time and space in redeeming love. Grant that we, living here and now, may plant and water the new garden of the Lord throughout the earth and for generations to come by the power of the sustaining Holy Spirit. Amen. And on these occasions, I do like to dig into my poetry collection just to break up the programme a little bit. So I'm going to got four poems tonight, and the first is a well-known and well-loved poet, Roger McGough. And this is, we've had a creation theme, environment theme to the weekend, and this is a tree walk yesterday. This is his poem, Trees Cannot Name the Seasons. Trees cannot name the seasons, nor flowers tell the time. But when the sun shines and they are charged with light, they take a day-long breath, what we call night, in their soft exhalation. And when joints creak yet again, and the dead skin of leaves falls, trees don't complain, nor mourn the passing of hours, what we call winter is simply hibernation. And as continuation comes to them as no surprise, they feel no need to divide and itemize. Nature has never needed reasons for flowers to tell the time, or trees put a name to seasons. Continuing in that spirit of caring for the beautiful natural world around us. That's me done for the start. Ladies and gentlemen, Mike and Ellis.
Thank you very much. Are you ready, Ellis?
Just about, Michael.
Are you sure?
I haven't done this for so long. I don't know which end is which. Right. Leo?
being for you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue, clouds of white, the bright, blessed day, the dark, sacred night. Then I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying,
and darling,
is the sky that we look upon.
Some lovely new lettuces ready for the next season. The slugs have been out, had them. So that put me to mind, why are they here? What happened back in the time of the flood? Why were they let on the ark? So this is Bad Day at the Ark by Roger McGough. One evening while the family were at Vespers, from the deck came the sound of furtive whispers. Impatiently, Ham waited for Amen, then crept up to investigate with Shem. Like phantoms in the moonlight, glistening with slime, two giant slugs were ranting, horns swaying in time. Sluggy deluge, sluggy dark, sluggy voyage, sluggy ark, sluggy seasick, sluggy sneeze, sluggy splinters, sluggy fleas, sluggy Noah, sluggy wife, sluggy boring, sluggy life. Each feculent slug was as huge as a rhino and smelled of old corpses rolled up in lino. Clammy, putrescent, oozing mucus and goo, the creator's revenge locked one night in the loo. Sluggy bellow, sluggy bleat, sluggy twitter, sluggy tweet, sluggy roar, sluggy meow, sluggy bow, sluggy wow, bow, wow, sluggy quack, sluggy moo, sluggy sink, the sluggy crew. Not only ugly, out of tune and glutinous, these beasts are revolting, said Shem, and mutinous. Let's do the deed. And do it big time. You get the sea salt, I'll get the quicklime. Sluggy quicklime, sluggy salt, sluggy human, sluggy fault, sluggy melting, sluggy pain. Endangered species down the drain. No one loves a sluggy slug. Gluggy, 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 glug. Noah, on hearing of the creature's cruel demise, summoned his sons and frowning said, now guys, our job is to save life, so you're way off the mark to make a floating abattoir out of an ark. This cannot go unpunished. And so tonight, no custard with your apple pie, all right? Let that be a lesson, adding with a smirk, giant slugs. Good riddance. Now, get back to work.
Follow that.
Mike and Ellis.
Follow that.
Yes, not heard that before. Right. The next thing we're going to do is something I heard on the internet, rather like, so we're going to sing it, but not as well as if you go on YouTube. Right, this one's called I'm Free.
The other?
Got the right harmonica?
Oh,
Seeing through someone else's eyes, actually what is lying in front of us in our garden lawns. Blades of green grass, seed heads bursting, dance and quiver in a sultry summer breeze. A sprinkling of daisies and yellow-throated buttercups surrounded by flies and midges and bees. A few dead leaves and some painted pink petals provide protective cover for red ants rummaging in the jungled undergrowth, crawling with food, spending their insect days searching and foraging. The ground beetle bumps into a red-spotted ladybird and goes on its way, ignoring and ignorant, passing an earwig and many-footed millipede, searching for manna in the age-old way. The desiccating earthworm sadly took a wrong turn and twists in the warmth of the life-denying sun. Black and golden honeybee hovers there in front of me before flying on again to make more honey for tea. Who would have thought it? Who would conceive it? A whole city in the lawn, and I didn't even know it. Surely there's something there for a would-be minor poet.
Right, we're going to calm it down a bit now for a hymn, What a Friend We Have in Jesus, but it's probably not quite how you would normally sing it with the organ.
Knows our every weakness. Take me.
My dad told me about them.
The Beatles. Yeah, I haven't heard of them.
I miss them myself.
Right, with a little help from my friend, I think you can join in on this one if you're allowed to, if you'd like to.
Especially the most of you box, I think, here tonight. Join in.
Right.
Two. Four.
What would you think if I sang out a tune? Would you stand and walk on me? Let me in ears and I'll sing you a song and I'll try not to sing out of key. Oh, I get by with a little help from my friends. Oh, I get by with a little help from my friends. Oh, I'm gonna try with a little help from my friends. What do I do when our love is away?
Doesn't worry to be alone.
How do I feel by the end of the day?
Are you sad?
What do you hope for the world? Lots of concerning news around for us at the time, all the time, now as soon as we switch on the TV or the radio. So this is about dreaming our way, envisaging a different kind of world, a different kind of future. What do you hope for the world? What are your dreams? Peace and justice? Food and shelter, lands and oceans that are healthy and clean. What do you hope for your country? What are your dreams? Freedom from oppression, just and generous government, available work and adequate housing, allotments and gardens and city parks. What do you hope for your friends and family? What are your dreams? Health and prosperity. Love between each other, safe spaces to grow up in, safe places to grow old. What do you hope for yourself? What are your dreams? It's good to dream. God is always dreaming, and dreams with God's help can become reality.
Amazing Grace, but not to the normal tune. This is Amazing Grace to the House of the Rising Sun.
Hopefully.
Yes.
Whisper words of wisdom, let it be.
when the broken-hearted people living in the world agree, there will be an answer, let it be. But though they may be parted, there is still a chance that they might see. There will be an answer, let it be.
These prayers are really thinking about those five senses as gift and the way that God gives to us in his generosity all these wonderful gifts. Five senses plus. Let us pray. Loving Father and Creator, we give you thanks and praise for all the good things of this life and for the five senses through which we can enjoy them. We thank you for the gift of sight, which enables us to enjoy beauty, colour, form and movement, both in the natural world and in the human world of art, craft and skill. We thank you for the sight of what is new, strange and spectacular, but also for the reassurance of familiar objects, places, people, not least the faces of those we love. For the gift of sight, we thank you. We thank you too for the gift of hearing, for music, laughter, birdsong, wind and storm, and also for the sound of voices speaking words of friendship, comfort, encouragement and inspiration, enlightening our minds and raising our spirits. For the gift of hearing, we thank you. We praise you for the sense of touch, for all things smooth and soft and warm, solid and firm, cool and soothing, the gentle touch of another hand breaking into our isolation and telling us we are not alone. The sense of touch, we thank you. We praise you for our sense of smell, for the fragrance of perfume and flowers, for wood smoke and coffee and the freshness of mown grass. For the sense of smell, we thank you. We thank you for the gift of taste, that the daily food we need to sustain us does not come plain and uninviting, but is garnished with delights of sweetness and sharpness, spiciness and savouriness, and a multitude of flavours. The gift of taste, we thank you. For these five senses, through which we keep in contact with the world around us, we give you our thanks. But we also thank you that we have another sense, which makes us aware of you. We cannot see you, and yet the light of your presence sometimes illumines our darkness. We cannot hear you, and yet the good news of your word brings the music of peace and hope into our lives. We cannot touch you, yet we sometimes feel your Holy Spirit moving among us. You are beyond our senses of taste or smell, and yet there is nothing sweeter than your love, and the perfume of your holiness fills every place where you are truly worshipped. The reality which lies beyond our senses, we thank you. We thank you, Lord, for the world of the senses which you have created. But we thank you more that you have broken through into that world in Jesus Christ and made us aware that there are realms of the Spirit greater than anything we might imagine, but closer than we might think. Now we see these things only dimly, but as we walk with Jesus, we look forward to the day when all things will be revealed in your eternal light. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
And together might we say the prayer, the Lord's Prayer, as it is written in your service sheet. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Right, another one where we hope you'll be clapping. So I'm going to set you off clapping and you can join in. Very easy. He's got the whole world in his hands. Are you ready? I said, are you ready?
Are you ready? Oh, that's better.
Good.
Are they still there?
Okay.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, right. Okay.
Here we go. Thank you very much.
So, close and then back over to you guys. So, can you believe it? It's 8 o'clock already. We've had a whole hour of Mike and Ellis and some poetry and some prayers, and we're at that time when we need to be coming to a close. And I'm going to do that firstly by thanking at this stage our two fantastic musicians and singers. And you lovely people for turning out at the close of what's been a wonderful but very tiring weekend of various things, and to renew some old friendships and to make some new ones. And I'm going to simply read out this rather beautiful blessing from the Iona community. And I have lost it. This is blessing and laughter and loving. Blessing and laughter and loving be yours. The love of a great God who names you and holds you while the earth turns and the flowers grow. This day, this night, this moment, and forever. Amen. Hope that you have very much enjoyed the evening. Look for our next Vespers, which will be hopefully sometime soon, hopefully when it will be. And I'm going to hand over again once more for the last time to Mike and Ellis. Thank you, guys.
All right. Well, this number, Sars number, is an Andy Williams song. You may remember.
Each day in the week be a good day. May the Lord always watch over you. Bye.
Yeah.